You've learned what Elastic Jobs are, but in this demo, you'll see how to actually go about creating them using PowerShell this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined once again by Kate Smith, a program manager on the Azure SQL team. Thanks for being with us today.
I'm excited to be here.
And today, we're continuing our series on Elastic Jobs, and we've talked about what are Elastic Jobs, as well as some of the important things you need to consider when you create Elastic Jobs, but now we're going to dive into how do you actually do this, and how do you do it with PowerShell? Now, Kate, can you start by telling us why someone might want to do this with PowerShell?
Sure. So you can create Elastic Jobs both using T-SQL and PowerShell, but PowerShell is it has the advantage of being, you know, more scriptable, all the advantages that come with PowerShell. There's some advantages to when you create the credentials, creating them through PowerShell, because then you can create them through the Elastic Jobs agent. You'll see that when I do the demo, or we'll talk about it when I do the demo, so that you can sort of, that all of a sudden the credentials that you create to connect to your target are associated directly with the Elastic Jobs agent and not with the just the general server. They're just associated, coupled tightly there. Yeah.
Awesome. Cool. Well, I know you have a lot that you have planned to show us, so let's get right into it.
Okay, cool. Okay, so before we dive into actually doing the demo, I've created some resources that we will be using for the demo. So I created a resource group that will hold all of the servers and databases that we're going to be using for this demo. This is a server that will host the Elastic Jobs agent, right? So database, which that database will then host the Elastic Jobs agent. So created a server and a database that will host the Elastic Jobs agent. But I haven't created the agent yet. And then I created two other servers, Elastic Jobs Target 1 and Elastic Jobs Target 2. Target 1 has two databases on it that we will target to run our Elastic Jobs against. And the Target 2 server has one database that we plan to run against our jobs against and one that we want to exclude. So I'll show you how to exclude a database from a server when we get to that. Okay, so what I have here is just a simple T-SQL that just says basically our job is just going to simply create a table called T. That's it. It's going to be a simple table. To make it idempotent, I have done this if not exists select part. And that way, if we run this again and again, we won't fail because the table already exists. We will just create the table when it doesn't already exist. Okay, so we know what our job is going to do, and we have targets for the job. So the next thing we need to do is we're going to do this in PowerShell. So let's open up our Cloud Shell. We already have a database created to host our Elastic Jobs agent. And so the first step is to bind that database to a variable. And then once that's bound, we can then use that database as the target of creating our Elastic Job agent. And I've named it PS Demo Agent, which is basically the PowerShell agent for this demo. That takes a bit. So my next step is to create credentials. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to just do that off video or whatever. Okay, great. So here we have our Elastic Jobs agent. Job agent has been created. And here we are. We've got our resource group, our server name, our database name, our agent, and it is ready to go. Cool. The next step is to create credentials, which I'm going to do off screen. So I'll go create those credentials, and then we'll come back and add our target groups and create the job. So now I've created the credentials and I have them created. And so I'm now going to create a target group. So I take the job agent and I create a new target group with the name PowerShell Demo Group. Awesome. Now, the next thing I want to do is to bind that group to a variable, which is pretty straightforward. Target group is now bound. And then I can use that to add the servers that I want. Now, I can add the server, keeping in mind that this credential and username already exist on the target server. So here we are. We got that working. We've got that refresh credential added, and that the server name added to our group. Now we go on, and we're going to do the same exact thing for the second server that I created, Elastic Jobs Target 2. Let me pull up the command here. Awesome. And then we need to actually exclude. There was one database we were going to exclude from that second server. So we issue this command, which calls out that same server, but the database that we want to exclude, and exclude it. Cool. So now we've created a target group, PS demo group, and it exists on our job agent. So now we need to create a job. So let's go back to our job agent and create a new SQL Elastic job, and we're going to name it PS demo because it's a PowerShell demo. That job is going to need some SQL text, and we talked about what that SQL text would be at the beginning. So we're just going to bind it here. Should look pretty familiar. And then we add a single job step to the job. We're going to call it step one. The job will have only one step. It will use our job credential, and the text will be SQL text one. I do need to fix the name of this, however, to be PS demo group. Awesome. And now we've created a job that has one step. It's on this group. It's using a job credential, and this is the text. Great. So there you have it. We have used PowerShell to create an Elastic Jobs agent. We have created the agent, we created the credentials off screen, and then we created the target group and the jobs.
Thanks, Kate. This has been really great. And I really like how, you know, with just a few simple PowerShell commands, you're really able to get this thing up and running. Yep. Now, I noticed that you labeled this step one. Is it possible to have multiple steps? And yes. Kind of how would I go about doing that?
You would basically do what I just did with the Elastic job step. And you would do you would just call it step two. And let's add some ad hoc SQL text here. And so now we've got two steps.
Got it. And I see that it has a step ID. So there's some order that's obtained in this job.
Yes, exactly. So we've got step ID 1, step ID 2, step 1, step 2, both in the same job. Exactly. And they're using the same credential.
Awesome. And now, you know, you mentioned they're using the same credential. What if I wanted to use a different credential, or I needed to use a different credential for a different step?
Yeah, that's very easy to do. You just have to create that credential on all your targets as before. Make sure that it has the permissions to do what it is you're trying to do with in that job step, and then just follow the same steps. It's just adding a second credential or an nth credential, as it were, and just using that when you create the step or add the step to the job.
Awesome. Cool. Well, thanks so much for showing us this today, Kate. And in the next video, I think we're going to dive in how to do the exact same thing, but using T-SQL.
Yes. Absolutely.
Awesome. And then in a future video, we're going to dive into how you actually go about scheduling and monitoring these things. So we still have a lot of exciting things to cover.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
So thanks for joining us today. We hope you enjoyed this episode. You know, leave us a comment, leave us a like to see what you want to see, to say what you want to see next time. And we hope to see you on Data Exposed.